You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to BorisFX.com for the premium download. Welcome back. One of the things we didn't really look at too much in our overview of the interface was this little tab down at the bottom here by the timeline, which is our nodes list. So the nodes list is broken up into several different categories. And within each category, we have different effects or nodes available to us. And if we're working in the standalone version of Silhouette, we'll also have Sapphire available here, where we can see the different effects available in a list as well, because there are just far too many effects just to have everything collapse down into one category. Let's head into the Silhouette category, where we have our core nodes. So let's take a look at some of the common functionality between them. Now we can bring nodes up in several different ways. One way is just to drag and drop into the trees area. Let's just delete that. Another way is to drag specifically onto another node, and that will connect it to that node. With a node selected, we could just double click, and that will connect it after that selected node. Get rid of that as well. And we can also hit the tab button and just start typing. So if we want Mocha Pro in there, just type in Mocha, and then we can choose that from the list. To remove a node from the tree, we can just delete it by having select and delete. Undo with Control or Command Z. Alternatively, we can just take the node, just shake it a little bit, and that will shake it free from the tree without deleting it. If I want to, I can then just bring it back in by moving it back over, and it will automatically connect. If I select multiple nodes, I can also shake those free from the tree as well. You'll see the nodes are also color-coded. Let's talk a little bit about the colors. I'm just going to add in a simple blur. And the reason I'm using a blur is because it's a straightforward node. So our input is shown in green. And if we look down at Roto, we have two green inputs available to us. One for the foreground and one for the background. At the bottom, we have our outputs. And with a blur, we actually only have an image output, which is in white, same as we have within Roto and within Mocha Pro. But you'll see that some nodes also have different colored outputs available as well. So the Roto node has three magenta outputs. So if I move over these, check out the bottom left-hand corner and see what's going on there. We can always see what element of a node we're looking at by looking in the bottom left-hand corner. So the magenta inputs and outputs are usually our auxiliary inputs and outputs. So in the case of Roto, we can take out things like the color composite, the full composite, or just channels. And in Mocha, we have an auxiliary input for bringing in an insert or for bringing in a secondary source. And you'll even see this is the same with things like the paint node, where we have our main input, which is green, and we have our auxiliary inputs, which are in magenta, and our main output, which is white, and our auxiliary output, which is paint only in this case, in magenta. Let's take a look at yellow now. So yellow means we have input and output for data, most commonly for things like objects or motion tracking, but some other things as well. And this is a way of transmitting data between nodes. In the case of paint, we have a data input. This lets us use motion tracking data or transform data from other nodes, as well as being able to limit the paint to specific objects as well if we desire. And if we check out the output here, we can take out things like objects, transform, and surface. And all of these are concepts we will return to later in the course. And the same for the Roto data output, where we can see we can take out objects, transform, surface, mesh, and crypto mat, and Mocha Pro, where we can take out objects, transform, surface, and mesh. So that's the yellow data port. One other color that is common with multiple nodes is the blue on the side of the node. And this is Obey Matte. And this is a way of limiting an effect to a specific area using either alpha or luma. And this is definitely something we will be returning to when we start to build up our composite. So now we have the basic anatomy of our nodes, the node structure, and our interface as a whole. And this can only mean one thing. We're actually ready to start working on our project. So join me in exercise 2 as we begin the journey to create our shot.